He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. They made him blow a bugle for his Uncle Sam. He couldn't run, because he couldn't jam. The captain seemed to understand. Because the next day the cat went out and drafted the band. And now the company jumps when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. He makes a company jump when he plays reveille. He's the boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. He was a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. And when he plays boogie woogie bugle, he was busy as a bee. And when he plays, he makes a company jump into the bar. He's a boogie woogie bugle boy of Company B. Do 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 do. Boogie every night, and wakes them up the same way in the early bright. They clap their hands and stamp their feet, because they know how he plays. When someone gives them a beat, he really breaks it up.
From the Hardwood Dance Floor of the Officers Club, back to the Blue Water Stage, Kathy and Jerry Lottie. Kathy and Jerry. The rest of our USO dancers. Sammy and Joe, Emily and Gia, and Carla and Aragon. In 1985, Marty McFly showed us that it was okay to look to the future while standing in the present. Tonight, Barla Studio gives you a look at the future of water sports with Mr. Troy Roper on his flyboard. Troy's flyboard is powered by that Yamaha water vehicle you see accompanying him. Troy uses the 5,000 gallons a minute put out by his dual power pump to do tricks just like that. The Yamaha water vehicle is loaned to us by the good people at Holiday Shores Marina and Boat Rental. Troy Roker going upside down. Now it's not only good in the air, it's good in the water as well. Let's watch as Troy swims like a dolphin. Troy Roker on his flyboard. You're going to hear this boat long before you see it. From the left, here comes race boat driver Jeremy Armstrong and the Team Mercury Racing boat. Now Jeremy just showed us the speed and the horsepower of that 300 horsepower Mercury outboard engine. Now he's going to show us the torque. Let's watch as he trims the engine up and prepares to do a tail stand. Now, in fairness to Jeremy, We didn't give him a running start the first time he came by. We're going to rectify that now. He's going to use all of Bartlett Bay. The next time you see him, he's going to be moving at over 80 miles an hour. Race driver Jeremy Armstrong in the Team Mercury Racing Boat. Well, you recognize the music. If you do, you know we're going back to high school. Back to the halls of Rydell High. The high school musical Grease. Now, in the movie, it was T-Birds versus the Scorpions. On the end of the starting dock, two T-Birds. Aragorn Lighting and Tyler High.
Lightning!
Now Aragorn has laid down a challenge to Tyler. Who can do the best jump off the ramp? You guys are going to help us decide by the sound of your applause and your cheers. Now each jumper gets one chance and one chance only at the ramp. They're going to use their best trick. Aragorn's going to show us his in 1 minute. And jumping these days, it's not how far you go, it's how you go far. And Aragorn's going to demonstrate that for us now. Aragorn running with a long distance front flip. What'd you think of that, Tyler? Tyler's not that impressed. Quickly into the fray. Now Tyler had an advantage. He got to stand in the starting dock and watch what Aragorn did. So he knows what he has to do better than. When he comes into view, he'll be far on the other side of the boat wake. He'll use a double wake cut to get back to the jump. It increases his speed and helps keep his line tight. From your right side, competitor number two of the T-Birds, Mr. Tyler Hyatt. Tyler moving out, the long distance skater. All right, it's time for you to help us decide. Who liked Aragorn's front flip?
Woo!
Tyler Hyatt's gainer. I couldn't agree more. Tyler Hyatt wins the challenge, but now it's time to get the gang back together. Three T-Birds and four tow ropes. We made Tyler up to that boat. We're going to do it using a crack the whip. All four T-Birds behind one boat. Well, now that the dispute is over, it's time for our T-Birds to start working together and show us a little teamwork and sportsmanship. When they come back into view, all four T-Birds will be hanging the far side of the way, just as Tyler showed us he could. At the last moment, two of those T-Birds will break formation and pull hard for the ramp. From your right-hand side. The double long-distance pretty impressive, but it still only involved two of the T-Birds. It's time to get all four involved in our next scene. When they come into view, two of the T-Birds will be bunched in the center. They're going to go over the ramp. Two T-Birds will be spread far to the outside. They'll be tapping their helmets and looking for a place to land. Two T-Birds over the top. The front flip, double split. Are you ready to see four T-Birds over the ramp at one time? Remember how crowded it got with three? Well, it's really going to be jammed up now. As they come into view, you'll see four T-Birds bumping and jostling and trying to find room on a ramp built for three. Four T-Birds with a four-man front flip. Boy, you've seen it all from this group. The one-on-one challenge, the front flip, the long-distance gainer, then the double gainer, the double front flip split, culminating with the four-man front flip. Our T-Birds have really displayed what teamwork and sportsmanship is all about. Let's welcome them back to the Blue Water stage. From left to right, Aragorn Lighting, Howard Hyatt, Troy Roker, and Jill Hardy. Oh boy, look out, we're starting, Doc. Aqua the Clowns, loose me out. Hey, Aqua, what are you doing out there, Aqua? He wants to be a T-Bird like those guys. Well,